photography and videography. And that's a large number. And 64% of our customers, they take their drones wherever they travel. I left San Francisco yesterday and I'm gonna go back this afternoon. And I brought my drone and I'm not even gonna fly it. I don't even know why I brought it, it just happened. It's fascinating. It is a new perspective. We have skypixel.com, which is an area where people can upload their images and we do a survey. And right now, 42% just do it to share images and videos. 7% really want to make a business out of it. It's about, you know, showing off the work and inspiring and getting inspiration. So it's quite interesting what these users are doing with the technology. All right, as I mentioned before, I'm going to go into something more fun. Last year, I was able to do a really fun project with Good Morning America, and we went into the world's largest cave in Vietnam. And not only did we go there, but we wanted to do a live broadcast out of the cave, flying a drone, and broadcasting the view from the drone live to the United States, something that had never been done before. So we did a survey trip. We went over to Vietnam. We went into the Phong Nha Kang Bang National Park, which is pretty much in central Vietnam, pretty close to the border of Laos. And there, this was the team. Very small, mostly engineers from ABC Good Morning America, and then there was me. And we had an attaché from Vietnam that made sure we didn't do anything weird. They were really unsure about us. And we got to the area, and it was breathtaking. It was exactly how I had envisioned Vietnam to be, just beautiful. And we had these porters who helped us carry all our equipment to the cave, which was a tremendous height. And we had an inspire, I had two inspires with me on that survey trip. And one we just put on a backpack so we could easily take it out and fly and not waste a lot of time. Our engineers had to look if they could get a satellite connection. We're in this valley and there are these huge mountains and we needed satellite connections so we could do the live broadcast. This is one of the two caves. This is Hang An, which is the third largest cave, and this ended up being our staging area, and we actually did the live portion out of this area because this was the only place we could get a satellite reception. It's not all glorious to do these kind of things. It's like camping, just a little worse because you actually have peeping toms. This little guy was in the middle of the night, was up there, and I had my flashlight, and I put my flashlight on a hook, and I hear this plop, and I look back up, and he was gone. And the plop, I'm convinced, was him jumping into the toilet. I didn't go that night. So then it was time to move out of Hang An and go over to the next location. That's Son Doong. Son Doong is the world's largest cave. It is unbelievable. It is a different world. Son Doong has two huge openings in the ceiling, 1,000 feet above the ground of the cave, that provide some daylight. And you need to use other people to really showcase how big this cave is. This is the second opening called Doong. And you can see it here really well, but there's actually a jungle growing inside the cave. And the jungle is beautiful and has animals in it that they don't find above Earth. It's just incredible. All right, we decided we can do it, and we went back a couple of weeks later with a full production trip team. As you can see, a little bit bigger team now. And
we've already taken you inside a volcano erupting.
Oh my God.
But now, for the first time, fly with us inside a spectacular new discovery so mammoth, you can finally fly a 747 inside. So we're flying in with drones, an epic live event inside a breathtaking hidden world buried beneath a jungle. This has never happened on live TV, and we're even swimming with 20 million jellyfish in the Pacific.
This is unbelievable.
Next week, see the world's new wonders live on Good Morning America.
So when we were preparing for the actual trip, they were running some of the pieces that we got in the survey trip. And it's kind of funny that they used these little toy drums in it. I got a chuckle out of that. Before I went back into the cave, I took advantage of capturing Vietnam from above, and I need to go back because this is such a beautiful place. We had so much equipment. We ended up with over 100 cases of equipment. On the drone side, we decided to bring 4 Inspires and 4 Phantoms. And we used the GPC cases, the professional cases, because they provided not only great protection, but very smartly designed, so we could utilize the most out of each case. Because if you go into a cave and you want to travel as light as possible, this time we had the opportunity to fly with a helicopter to the entrance of the cave, and that was awesome because we didn't have to hike through the jungle. And this machine, MI-18, is just, it was incredible. It was an amazing experience. And before we left the little village, we had all the kids out, and they enjoyed flying the drones with us and seeing the helicopter take off. So that was a lot of fun. And then we got back to Hang In, and flying inside the cave is a completely different experience. And I have learned that flying in a room the size of this is so much easier than flying in a cave the size of that, because you have absolutely no depth of perception. So it was an amazing experience. This is what it looked like at the evening of the live broadcast. Over there on the side, you can see where we set up a camp that we then showcased in the piece. And then all the equipment on the bottom is all technical equipment to make a live broadcast possible. And somehow, our engineers outside at the satellite dish managed to get beer. I still don't know that. So then, before we did the live broadcast, we went back into hanging into Son Dong, and we did taping features that then were shown throughout the show. And here we're rappelling down into the cave, and this is what it looked like from the drone. So you can see where the light is, the opening, and we had to rappel about 500 feet down with all the equipment, which was quite challenging. And even though it's the world's largest cave, there are areas where you can barely fit through, and it got challenging to get cases through these openings because no matter how hard you push, physics just doesn't allow for certain things to go through certain openings. The view inside the cave was just, it was like out of a movie, seriously. And what we constantly ended up doing was charging batteries. So that's really right now a piece that limits the use of the technology to 20 or 30 minutes, and we were constantly charging batteries. Now, this is a view that nobody had ever had before. This is one of those dough lines, openings in the ceiling of the cave. So we flew from 1,000 or from 0, 1,000 feet up. We got to the opening, and then we went another 500 feet out, and we looked down, and it's just incredible that we can do that. And then in the morning, the sunlight comes in from those dough lines, and it looks out of Avatar. In fact, this could be Avatar. So here is our Ginger. She is with ABC Good Morning America, standing on this stalagmite, and we're just flying the drones around her. You can see one of the Inspires in the background. And this is just an amazing way of discovering the cave. It almost looks unreal. The conditions in the cave were pretty harsh for the equipment. After every flight, it's so humid, the machines are completely drenched, and you really have to take care of your equipment, and there's dust, and the humidity just, it's really harsh on the equipment. And there are no flat spots, so you usually land on the smallest of areas, or then you hand catch it, which I do not recommend. But, there are just so many things that you can do. So here's Ferdinand, and Ferdinand is a German pilot, in my opinion, one of the world's best drone pilots. Now, one thing about Ferdinand, look at this shirt. I look at mine. That guy never sweats. I was so upset because he was always dry, and I was like completely dry. drenched because the humidity is just tremendous in there. This is the second dough line. This is a vertical panorama. So when you're on the bottom, you look straight down, and then towards the top of the image, you look towards the horizon. But this is the area I mentioned before where you have an entire jungle that grows inside the cave about 600 feet below the surface. So this is now the day of the live production. And as you can see, there's so much equipment that needs to be connected. And we were doing a test run, and while nobody was watching, I was unplugging one plug. And that was the one plug that controlled everything. They had no idea. And everybody got scrambling. But of course, they figured out that it was me, and so I was not allowed anywhere near the plugs anymore. As it happens, 5 minutes before we went live, a huge thunderstorm came over the area. And we had three channels going from us to the satellite. One for the ground camera, one for the drone camera, and one for communications. And the communications channel went dead. We had no idea when New York wanted us to be live on the drone. So we just had to wing it. We are in central Vietnam, just outside of the hidden world of Son Doong. Son Doong is the world's largest cave system, and what we're doing here is we're writing TV history. Together with an ABC Good Morning America team and their engineers, we will be live broadcasting out of the hidden world of Son Doong. Into the jungle by means of a helicopter because we had so much equipment. At